It's the key question about the COVID vaccines that couldn't be answered in a lab. How long will I be protected? Now a UK study analysing the Pfizer, AstraZeneca and Moderna vaccines' effectiveness against the Delta variant is offering some answers.
We do certainly need to understand how long protection lasts and over what time period it reduces and by what amount. And we're getting some great research coming in now that shows there are reductions in protection over time, but in fact it's relatively modest.
Firstly, looking at symptomatic disease, researchers found that 20 weeks after the second dose, AstraZeneca's protection fell to 47.3% and Pfizer to 69.7%, with a steeper decline of both vaccines observed in over 65s.
The main one that these vaccines perform tremendously well at is preventing from severe disease. And even out to those 6-month mark or around there, the protection from that severe disease does remain very high.
While it's good to know the vaccines will keep most of us from even getting sick months after our shots, the other crucial metric is protection against hospitalisation. On this, the researchers report a limited waning beyond 20 weeks, with Astra delivering 77% protection and Pfizer 92.7%, 5 months after dose two.
We do know these vaccines have enormous benefit in terms of reducing the burden on the health system. They perform tremendously well, but of course also on reducing the number of people infected and the number of people that they go on to infect.
The outlier in this research is Moderna's mRNA vaccine. Introduced several months after the other jabs, there's less available data on rates of hospitalisation. But its protection against symptomatic infections seems to hold steady above 90%, even 14 weeks after two doses. It's worth remembering that back at the start of the pandemic, researchers were quoted saying if we get one vaccine with 50% or higher efficacy, then we'll be very happy.
It's funny that we've focused on some of the limitations of these vaccines, but in actual fact, they've performed far better than we ever anticipated. And to have a selection of vaccines with efficacy rates in the 80 to 90% range would have been something that we would not have thought realistically possible at the very beginning. And so I think we do need to recalibrate our thinking about the high-performing vaccines that we have available to us.
Two Hellier boys got their jabs this week, right. And Oscar will get his on the weekend. And
Ollie's booked in next week.
Yeah. And they're really excited.
Yeah, the kids are mad for it.
Yeah.
Well, they're not protesting in their hives.
No, absolutely not. But yeah, it's I just still most days just like thanks science. And to see what Paul was saying about what their expectations were.
Yeah, 50%. And now sometimes in the 80s. Yeah.
Well, and now we're going to get a whole lot of new vaccines that are even better coming out of the next generation. It's been incredible. Yeah. From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed.